Pope Francis has made it quite clear that he intends to visit Africa. He's made that very remark more than once. The first time was in January while he was returning from his trip from Sri Lanka and the Philippines, and then again in the massive gathering of priests in Rome.
Si Dios quiere, estaré en África en el mes de noviembre. En la República Centroafricana primera y en Uganda después. Queda como posibilidad, pero todavía no es segura porque hay problemas allí para la organización Kenia.
The visit will take place at the end of November, and Monsignor Juan José Aguirre will welcome Pope Francis to the Central African Republic.
We are very happy that the Central African Republic will be able to welcome the Pope. Not only Catholics, Protestants and Muslims also see this visit as a divine blessing.
The Spanish bishop, who was also a missionary, has lived in the African country for more than 36 years. In the past 2 years, he has witnessed the violence caused by the Seleka, which is a jihadist faction, and also their enemies, the anti-Balaka. Both are said to be equally bloodthirsty. Each of them oppresses a population already struggling to survive.
The Central African Republic is ranked as the second poorest country in the world. We have undergone severe political suffering in the past, and since 2013, we have suffered even more. The Pope will find an enormous amount of poor people here who live on less than a euro a day, and yet he will find that these people are very religious.
That poverty, though, should not define, says the bishop, people from the Central African Republic. The Pope will find people who are looking for hope. These are some pictures the bishop has carried out in his diocese of Wangazu. A few days ago, the bishops of the Central African Republic met with Pope Francis during their ad limina visit. Monsignor Juan José Aguirre wasn't able to attend because he suffered a heart attack, the third one he's had in the past few years. But weeks later, after recovering, he visited Rome. This time, he spoke directly with Pope Francis.
I met with him for a few minutes, and I was able to talk about the Central African Republic. He was very interested in the country. The entire population of the Central African Republic has great hopes that the Pope, merely by his presence, will bless both our electoral process and its result.
And this is what people are hoping will be obtained through the Pope's visit: the election of a new president who will give the country much-needed stability. Another is the disarmament of the militias, many of which are made up of kidnapped child soldiers. Despite the challenges, Monsignor Aguirre says there is still hope. And it's that very country, the bishop says, has given him a new attitude towards life and faith.
Si volvieran a hacer, volvería a hacer lo mismo.
If I were born a second time, I would do everything the same way. Just like the poet Pablo Neruda says, I confess that I have lived. My life has been filled with precious moments, moments that make my heart swell with gratitude.